Now, I'm a pretty big fan of open large language models like the Gemma models, the Qwen models, and so on. That's also why I created a separate course on that, where I teach you how to efficiently run such models locally on your system with tools like Ollama or LM Studio. And therefore, I was quite excited when last week at Google I.O., Google did not just announce all the Gemini updates and Project Astra and Mariner, which are also interesting and about which I also already talked in a separate video, but when they also announced Gemma 3N, a new open model. And I don't think it was in a keynote, I think it was in a separate session, but it's pretty exciting, because just like the other Gemma 3 models, it will be an open model, but it will be quite a bit different. Now, unlike the other Gemma 3 models, you can't use it just yet, or not in LM Studio and Ollama, at least. Right now, when I'm recording this, it's not available there. Instead, you can use it in preview mode, but of course, it will very likely be available through other means in the near future, hopefully. Because the exciting thing about Gemma 3N is that it's actually a combination of two models merged into one. It's a 5 billion and a 8 billion parameters model. And what's interesting is not just that it's two models in one, and I'll get back to that, but also that Google applied various optimization techniques to shrink the memory footprint of these models from 5 and 8 billion down to 2 and 4. So you get the performance and the power of 5 and 8 billion parameter models, which is still not super huge, but decent, and for many tasks it will be more than enough. But you have the memory footprint of even smaller models. And the advantage here is that you can run this model on relatively low-end devices. That's the plan, at least potentially maybe even on some smartphones. And that, of course, would be great if you had your local AI even on non-high-end devices. That's the idea here. Now, how did Google do that? In the end, they, of course, still built a large language model that works the way other large language models work too, but they used a new architecture, a new approach that essentially allowed them to have shared layers in that neural network that powers the large language model. So there are certain parts of the neural network that are used by both models, and then there are some parts that are only used by one of the two models. And therefore, as an application developer who aims to use that locally running model, for example, to me, it sounds as if you will be able to tell this model, so to say, or the application that hosts the model, which of the two versions of the model you want to use, the bigger one or the smaller one. And for some tasks, like for example, text summarization, the smaller one might be all you need, and the advantage of using that instead of the bigger one would be better performance, higher speed. So the results might be worse, but for text summarization, there might not be a difference actually, but the results will be available quicker. Now, if you, for example, need the model for content generation, where you want to get the best possible quality, there you might opt for the bigger, a bit smaller model. But your users, or you if you're running it on your system, you don't have to download and install different models and unload them from memory and load them back into memory, which takes up disk space and time. Instead, you would have one model that has both in it, and by downloading and installing it once and by running it once, you would be able to seamlessly switch between these two different integrated models. So that's pretty exciting. What's also pretty exciting is not just the numbers shared by Google regarding the performance of this model. You should always take those with a grain of salt, of course, but still, it's quite impressive to see how well this Gemma 3N model, seems to perform, for example, compared to Claude 3.7. But it's not just that, but what's instead also pretty interesting is that this model will be multimodal. So it does not just support text input, but for example, also video or audio input or images. So as they're saying in their article, Gemma 3N can understand and process audio, text, and images and offers significantly enhanced video understanding. And for example, due to these audio capabilities, you will be able to use this model to transcribe audio, to create captions for a video, for example, and also to translate audio. And that, of course, combined with the fact that it can run locally on your system and potentially even on devices like smartphones that could unlock brand new possibilities for developers and application builders, but also for you if you just want to use it locally on your system for content generation, text summarization, and so on. And you could reap all the benefits you get from an open model, like the 100% privacy, since it's running on your machine, no data leaves your machine, but also, of course, the fact that you don't have to pay for it, you don't need a subscription, and that you can get great results for many tasks like text summarizations on. So these are in general advantages of using open models. That's why I use and like them a lot. But these are, of course, therefore also advantages of Gemma 3N, which combined with its new architecture and this two-in-one model approach and this reduced memory footprint, makes this really, really promising for using it locally, for integrating it into applications, and so on. So I'm super excited to see how this will develop and when we'll be able to use it through Ollama or other tools. And as always, let me know what you think of that, if that's something you're totally not interested in, or which potential use cases you see for open models like this.